everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more Final Fantasy X, and we're gonna do the Area Conquest Monsters. I haven't played this in like a week, so my explanations are basically going to be just be me going off what it says on the wiki and kind of what I vaguely remember from the last time I played this, which the last time I played this, I went through all these guys off screen and beat all the ones that I wasn't 100% sure I could beat already. So, without further ado, let's do the sounds. Hi-yah! Fenrir has three attacks, one which does proportional damage and confuses the target, one that is an instant kill, and one that's just a regular attack. It'll only confuse one party member at a time, and all of its attacks are single target, so Auto Phoenix will... So, you know, an efficient reviving setup will completely nullify anything he can do. Unfortunately, his evasion is so high that it's almost impossible to hit him, so just use something like attack reels or an overdrive, because overdrives are guaranteed to connect. Ornithelestes is pretty much the exact same situation as Fenrir, except it can't confuse. Instead, it will try to poison you and drain your HP with Drain Touch. Either raise your accuracy with stuff like aim and jinx and luck, or, yet again, use something like attack reels or an overdrive, or otherwise an overdrive. Obviously, that is an overdrive. Never mind. Taryx will target all party members with an attack that ignores the Protect status on its first turn and inflicts Curse. It has really high evasion, but also really, really low HP. It only has 100,000 health. So if you can actually hit it, it goes down in seconds. Oh my god, another light enemy that's hard to hit! This thing can inflict a bunch of status ailments with its regular attack, and it also has a 100% chance of instant death unless, as long as you're not protected by it. It can use Bewitching Stab to confuse you, and it can use Kiraga to heal itself. It has 600,000 HP, so, you know, put it away. If you can hit it. Otherwise, use an overdrive. Vidatu has a permanent null to all four elements, and primarily attacks with Ultima. However, it has less than 100,000 HP, and so can be one-shot. Assuming you can hit it. One-Eye has very low HP, only 150,000. However, it has a very dangerous attack called Shockwave that'll try to confuse everybody, among other stuff. So if it hits you with that and you're not protected, it could spell doom, but it's not hard to kill it before it can do that. It doesn't even have that high evasion. The Jumbo Flan has 1.3 million HP, a complete immunity to physical attacks, and absorbs all elements except for non-elemental spells and holy. Your best course of action is to cast Reflect on yourself and bounce Flare and Ultima spells back onto it, because it also has an auto-reflect that you can't dispel, and boost your special defense with stuff like Focus so that you can survive its Ultima and Flare attacks. this fight is going to take a long time no matter what you do, so get ready because you're in it for the long haul. With the Nega Elemental, its second verse, same as the first, right down to having the same obscene 1.3 million HP. This one absorbs all elements, including Holy. It isn't immune to physical damage, but it will reflect all normal physical and special attacks with Ultima. For some reason, it doesn't counter double cast, though, so you can whittle it down with that. And completely avoid anything it has that will attack more than one person at once. So just plug away, you're gonna be here a while. Tankit is slow, but he has some very nasty tricks. His regular attack inflicts Berserk and also delays the target's turn for like a good long while, and if only one party member is alive at any point, it'll continuously attack until it finishes you off. Yeah, it's cheap like that. It is also armored, as you can see, it's one of the armored enemy types, so use Banishing Blade or a Frag Grenade to break its armor, and then just try and keep more than at least two people alive at all times. Otherwise, you're gonna be fucked. Fafnir's biggest threat is its triple attack move, where it attacks once, then hits everybody with a certain element, and then attacks again. The element it can use is random between fire, lightning, and ice. And it's also armored, so yet again, another thing you want to use Banishing Blade on so that you can do any damage at all. Also, it has over a million HP, so this fight could take a while if you aren't really, really leveled up. Null spells work well. Just don't bother with Null Tide because he never attacks with water. Sleep Sprout will always use Good Night on its first turn, which is an obscenely powerful attack that is guaranteed to put everybody to sleep for like 100 turns. It also uses this as a counter to pretty much anything, but it has less than 100,000 HP, so a sufficiently powerful party member can one-shot it. The Bomb King is weird. Unlike other bombs, it won't self-destruct after you attack it three times and it grows to its third and final size, or its fourth and final size, I suppose. Instead, it will start spamming Ultima, which you don't want to deal with. Luckily, counterattacks actually do not provoke it to grow, so what you can do is bring in Auron, whose celestial weapon has, bring in a character with counterattack on their weapon, such as Auron with his Masamune, and have them use Sentinel to guard against all attacks in its first phase, where it only uses physical attacks. That way, he'll just attack and attack and attack and attack. Or he'll attack your party member when it has counter, and then they'll counter back and damage it. It only has like 500,000 HP, so it's not too bad. If you do knock it into its second phase, Fire Eater armor can be used to completely mitigate any attack it does, as long as you don't grow it to the point where it starts using Ultima. Juggernaut has 1.2 million HP and a complete immunity to magic, really high strength of defense, and it's armored, so use Banishing Blade first of all. Its only really dangerous attack, however, is its Salvo move, which will hit everybody with fire. So obviously, because it is fire elemental, you can protect from it with Null Blades. Other than that, all it has is single targeting attacks. And it's pretty slow. And finally, we have Ironclad at a staggering 2 million HP. He's a cut above the rest within the species conquest creations. He's armored, so you want to use Banishing Blade to get rid of that. And his attacks are extremely powerful, and he counters like everything, and he has attacks to hit everybody. Honestly, I'm not 100% sure what to do here. I might not be able to beat this guy. If I can't, then I guess you're probably going to be seeing this part in real time. Otherwise, I think it's just tank and spank. You just need to have high enough stats. Apparently 200 evasion is enough to dodge everything he has, which just seems like... Oh, God, that would be such a pain in the ass to build up, though. Oof. Oh, way to go, Tidus. Whew! Oh man, I can't believe I actually beat that guy. Well, there you go. That's all the area that's species conquest. I always get those mixed up for some reason. Because I think, okay, area sounds bigger than species, but no. Species is bigger than area because species can be across many areas. Anyway. Well, that was all the Species Conquest monsters. I'm glad that worked out. Now I get to go edit this and pick music out for all these. And next time on Final Fantasy X, I will have done a whole bunch of grinding, and we will be in literal endgame level power, probably. Like, I'll probably be strong enough that I could take on most of the Dark Aeons. I might be able to take on some of them right now, actually. Probably could. Some of the weaker ones, What the hell's his name? Ifrit. Jeez. Okay. Bye.